We talked about variables in the first video, and now I'd like to show you a little bit more how they work. So, as you remember from the first video, in JavaScript, which is the language we're working in, if we type alert, open parenthesis, and then something, close parenthesis, and put in a semicolon, and then run it, it'll pop up and say, hello world. Oh, and as an aside, this is jsfiddle.net. You see the URL right there. This is a place where you can go and work with JavaScript without having to have any of the other technology that goes along with it. The reason we're using JavaScript is, as I mentioned earlier, it's very common on the web, and Khan Academy and Code Academy both have modules on JavaScript. So we see this is how alert works. Now, a quick note on something called concatenation. It's basically adding one thing to another. We do that with the plus symbol, as you might expect. So if we do hello world and put something else, like yay, and run it, then that shows up. This comes in handy when we do things like, we say var width equals 10, semicolon, and we can change this to width and run it, and we get that value. So you can see this is a variable. This is an assignment. We can do things like this, put quotes around it, and now it's a string, but it doesn't make that any different. So if we create another variable, go variable height equals 20, and that's really it for variables in JavaScript. There are also different types of data structures and things, but we'll get to those in a second. Now I would like to show you an if. So if we go if width is equal to, that's what the double equals means, height, and then we need the curly bracket and close the curly bracket. If those are equal, then we need another variable. We'll call this variable square, and we're not assigning it a value. Then square equals true. If we're putting an else, that's the otherwise portion, closing the curly bracket, and put square equals false. Now basically what this is doing is it's looking at the value in width, comparing that to the value in height, and if they are the same, which they're not, if they are the same, then it assigns the value of true to square. If they're not the same, it applies the value of false. So now we're gonna, right here, we're gonna put square in, and now we're gonna run that, and it says false. Now you may be thinking, well, there are quotes around 10, so of course it's false. But if we make this the same number and run it, it says it's true. That's because we're using this double equal, so it's just looking at the value of it, not what the value represents. So if we, to maybe illustrate this a little more, if we make this a triple equals and run it, then it says it's false. So that's just something to know about JavaScript. This can be useful in certain circumstances. Now, suppose these are true, and we want to know what the area of the square is. Well, let's define a function. So if we say function area, parentheses, and then brackets. Now, in order to find the area, we need to know what the width and the height of our square is, because as you know, the area of a square is width times height. Once we have that, we can type in alert and say the area is, and then add the value of width times height to that output. Now to call our function, we need to do something like this. We need to type the name of the function and then include the values that go along with it. Now when we run that, we should get the area is 100. Now, let's actually go ahead and comment this out. That's what it's called when you use these double slashes to make something a comment. It's called commenting it out. Now if we change this value, say we make this 2 and run it, you see it's 20. See how that works? So that's a function. This is an if. And this is a comment, and this is a function call. It's pretty straightforward. It should be pretty simple after all of the work you've done with spreadsheets. So now let's look at something else. So I talked about arrays and loops in the previous video as well. So here we see an array. In JavaScript, the way you create an array is just like a variable. You say variable var, variable name equals, and then it's a square bracket, and then whatever values you want it to hold separated by commas. Now these can be anything. They don't have to be strings. They can be numbers or anything. In our case, we're just doing them with strings just for illustration. And this is a for loop, and it takes this structure. It says for, and then you have to have some kind of variable that's a counter, something to keep track of where it is in the loop. Then a comparison of that counter with whatever condition. In this case, it's cars.length. Now what that is saying is you have the variable cars, and it has some functions associated with it. Length is one of them. And what this returns is how many items there are in that list. It's basically the same as the count function that we looked at in spreadsheets. And then you have this, which this is sometimes a little confusing. This is an incrementer. Basically what that means is every time this goes through the loop, when it gets to the bottom, it adds one to this variable. So basically it runs through this, it adds one, and then it goes through the loop again. I think it's easiest to see this by executing this loop. So when we run this, this is what we get. It says car zero is a sob. That's car plus this variable is a plus this variable. So it's accessing the zeroth element of this array. So if it's 0, 1, 2, 3, this is the zeroth element. So then we say okay, and it goes through the loop again. And it says car 1 is a Volvo. It's added 1 to this variable. It's saying car plus that variable is a plus this variable at the new index. Again, it goes through the loop. Car 2 is a Scion, so it's gone through, and once it's hit the bottom of this loop, it adds 1 to I. It goes through again, car 3 is a Honda. And that illustrates that arrays are typically started at 0, much like this course. 0, 1, 2, 3. And that's a for loop. Now I want to look at while loops. And we have the same array from before. Now the difference between a while loop and a for loop is, with a for loop, as you remember, all of the sort of incrementing and tracking was taken care of within the structure. In a while loop, it kind of comes from somewhere else. So we have to declare a new variable. This we're calling I. It's an incrementing variable, and I is sort of a standard counter. You'll have I and J typically when you're counting things with programming. So it's saying while I is less than cars.length, so it's while I is less than the number of items in this array, do this loop. And this loop consists of pop up an alert window, then increment I. So if we run that, we'll see it does the same thing as before. It's saying car 0 is a Saab, car 1 is a Volvo, car 2 is a Scion. What it's doing is it's going through while this loop is true and saying alert, do this thing. Alert car, whatever values in I is a whatever's at car's position I, and then add one to I and go through again. So you see, that's how while loops work. Now, you can see how these might be useful in that if you have a big long list of things, you can use these to go through them. These are known as control structures or control loops, and they're very powerful and something that is used all the time in programming. So we talked about different types of variables. Here we have a variable called height that holds 0. Now 0 is an integer. Now if we run this value, we see it says height is 0. Now what we're doing is we're calling an alert box with the string height, and we're concatenating this variable. Now say we have this and we want to have put something else in there. We can put height equals 23, and then just copying and pasting, putting this here and executing it again, and it says height is 0 and then height is 23. So you see we're reassigning that value. Now remember, if we put the double equal sign, that's not going to change the value, because this is a comparison. And also note, we can put whatever we want in here when we are reassigning it. It doesn't matter if it stays an integer or not. See, this is the new value. Height is 5. Now one other thing I would like to show you. The typical way of incrementing something is by appending two plus signs to it. So you'll see this will display one on the second go around. Height is 0, height is 1. You can also do this by saying height equals height plus some value. And you see how that works. These are just sort of ways of incrementing variables or adding things to it. The reason you might want to do this is adding plus plus always adds 1. You can also subtract 1 by going height minus minus. But you may want to add or subtract more than 1. Like say you wanted to go through by 5s, or if you wanted to go through by 3s, then you could do it this other way, saying height equals height plus 3. So if we display this, basically what this will do, let's do this to make it a little bit more interesting. Basically, this is going to take it from 0 to 57. It's going to add 1, make it 58, subtract 1 again to make it 57, 56. Then it's going to add 3, making it 59. So when we run that, we say height is 0, it does all its work, and we get height is 59. This is just a way of doing assignments and incrementation. It's just something that's used a lot in programming.